DJ from a young age was athletic. On October 31st, 2006, what started out as a normal day ended up being the worst day of my life. He went to the first basketball practice of the season and collapsed and died. This is a picture of DJ shooting a free throw.
When Billy Stahlschmidt's 15-year-old son DJ died in 2006, he became one of about 75 young athletes who die every year of sudden cardiac death. Of those, about a third are caused by a heart condition called hypertrophic cardiomyopathy, a genetic condition where during the teenage years the heart begins to thicken abnormally.
One of the syndromes would be the susceptibility to have an arrhythmia when they exercise. So a child could have a thickened heart, not know about the condition, and then while they're playing sports, while they're on the basketball field, their heart could suddenly race and they could die. This valve over here is the mitral valve.
According to Dr. Keith Mankiewicz, Washington University cardiologist at Burns Jewish Hospital and Burns Jewish West County Hospital, many parents and children don't recognize symptoms or simply disregard them. The symptoms are shortness of breath, chest discomfort, rapid heartbeats, or passing out.
I think that most young kids think that they're healthy, and when they do develop shortness of breath related to a sporting event, they probably think they're just out of shape. But I think we need to create an awareness that if they're more short of breath than they should be, then they should be evaluated further.
He says that can be done by educating parents, students, physicians, and coaches to not only be aware of symptoms young athletes complain about, but to let the young athlete know they may have to turn to different, less exerting sports.
It's extremely difficult for some kids who their lives revolve around sports to tell them that they are not allowed to exert themselves. And there are some kids who listen to our advice and there are some kids who ignore our advice. But we need the child, the parent, and the school to be aware that they have a potentially dangerous condition and that the guidelines set out by the American Heart Association is that they should not exert themselves.
As a parent, I think the biggest misconception is that my child is healthy. Parents need to realize that this is happening to seemingly healthy teenagers.
Both Stahlschmidt and Dr. Mankiewicz agree schools should not only have external defibrillators, but also be trained in how to use them.
Can you take a deep breath?
In addition, schools should use annual physical exams endorsed by the American Heart Association.
Most schools don't have an awareness of the risks that athletes are at. And I would stress that it's extremely important for every school to have some kind of program where they have an awareness that one of the athletes could die during exercise. And if we look at the potential risks for kids dying, you know, there's at least 75 children who die every year. And every school is potentially at risk for one of their pupils dying on the sports field. And they should do everything they can to prevent a catastrophe from happening.
It's not always about winning. It's about these kids living long, healthy lives.
Dr. Mankiewicz has a special clinic devoted to young athletes. For more information, visit www.barnesjewish.org.